Good afternoon. How are you? How is everybody today? Did you celebrate Halloween yesterday? Well, today is el Día de los Muertos. Today is the Day of the Dead, when we call our ancestors. Llamamos a nuestros ancestros. ¿Cómo los llamamos? How do we call them? We put an ofrenda, and we put things that they like on that ofrenda so they'll come down. In Guatemala, they do kites. They send these big kites up into the air to bring down and call your ancestors. And later, at 2 o'clock, you'll hear more stories of how we call our ancestors. And we also dance for them. So today, the Danza Tecuanes is going to do a very, very interesting dance for you. And they're going to, and at 1 o'clock, that's 11, and at 1 o'clock, they're going to do El Baile de los Viejitos, the dance of our ancestors. So today, we're going to start celebrating El Día de los Muertos, All Souls Day, the Day of the Dead. And tomorrow is another important day, El Día de los Inocentes. We also keep celebrating until tomorrow. So the ofrenda will be up also tomorrow. Entonces, los tecuanes, I'm going to turn the mic over to Mr. Reyes, who's going to tell you a little bit about the dance that they're going to be doing.
Well, good morning to everyone. Thank you for being here with us in this special celebration. The dance of Tecuani, from the Nahuatl language, Tecuani, the one who is people, is a singular and unique representation of a fight that took place in small towns in southern Mexico. Through their way of dancing, dancers sought to scare away anything that could represent any danger to their families. The greatest of these dangers was the jaguar. This animal had a special significance in all Mesoamerican cultures. It was given divine attributes. The opening piece, it's called Dedication. It's a representation that will start with the show. It will start the same way it originally did. Dancers would go to in a procession to the place of adoration. The second piece will be Dance to Sombrero Ortiz. This dance is performed to honor and remember an important person in the dance. Dancers will twirl around in the air, imitating the way he used to dance. The next one would be the Dance of the Sugarcane Harvest. The Dance of the Sugarcane Harvest is a piece that tries to represent the actions and moves needed in that farming activity. Dancers will jump happily as if carrying a bundle of cane sticks on their shoulders. And lastly, the Dance of the Cape. This is a lively and happy piece where dancers will prepare for the time when they will be fighting the bull. Thank you, and we hope you enjoy the show. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.